Welcome and thanks for joining me while I draw out these stickers. In last week's video, I started to make a sticker design, but it turned into a full illustration. I ended up really liking the characters and decided to make a sticker sheet with them along with just a bunch of cute little things. This is my first time making a sticker sheet, but I feel like it should be pretty easy to do. For anybody who's interested, I've set the canvas size to 8.5 by 11 inches, since that's what my printer uses, and the DPI is at 300, which is standard for printing. I didn't really have a solid idea or style I was going for here, I just wanted to make something cute. So I tried to stay loose and not overthink anything. And with this inking, I wanted a slightly sketchy feel, so I held myself back a lot from trying to make perfect lines. I do like how it turned out, especially later on after I changed the colors of the lines. Ooh, as a side note, I took one of those like silly quizzes on Pinterest the other day to find out what I would be if I wasn't a human. And according to that, I am a houseplant. And to be honest, I'd rather be a tree, just out there in the wild photosynthesizing. But at the same time, I'd probably be very content being a houseplant so long as my human knows how to take care of houseplants. But I don't know, maybe that's me. Of course, you know, mushrooms would be fun too. I added the mushrooms with this Stay Wild sticker because nothing's more wild than a mushroom. They do what they want. You can't control the fungi. For this one, I did intend to have more of a like a cute little cheapy style with it, but I don't know, it didn't work out kind of the first time I started drawing, and I didn't feel like fighting with the style, so I just kind of made something more just very simplified and cute. But I don't know, it's not my favorite, but I also don't dislike it. She has a little thought bubble up there, and I thought this was going to be a lot more coffee themed when I started, and it just, I don't know, the coffee theme sort of faded away and I kind of went more for kittens and plants and just hearts and stuff. After the really simplified style, I really wanted to do something a little bit more like the original illustration, but not quite as finished. So this is what I ended up with, and this one actually is one of my favorites of the stickers, maybe mostly because of how the kitten turned out. It just like looks like an adorable little loaf who's suddenly interested in something, and I don't know, I just like it. It's happy, it's cute. So this is the teacup that I also didn't really fight with, but if I were to do it again, I just want to make it a lot cuter. It's just a basic coffee mug, but or tea mug with I told you so tea. And I really wanted to make the kitten on it just, I don't know, cute, but it didn't really, it's not uncute. It's not really enough. It needs to be cuter. I should have made it cuter, but didn't have it in me at the time, I guess. Maybe in the future I'll make more mugs. Because they're warm and comfy and cute, but potentially sassy. For these other ones, I really just wanted something happy and cute while I filled up like the empty space. So you get stars, you get hearts, you get rainbows, you get a happy sun behind clouds. All stickers that I would use. If I actually use stickers, I don't actually use the stickers that I have usually because I always feel like there's always a better place to put them. And I could use them for like my on my computer or something. But I always, I don't know. I like collecting stickers, but I just don't like using them. Don't think I'm the only one who does that, but I could be wrong. Do you use all of your stickers? When I was little, I used to collect stickers, all of my like school stickers with the stars and the smiley faces and you know, telling you that, oh, good job, here's a sticker. I used to have like a folder that I would just stick all of the stickers in to collect them. They weren't really like cute stickers like these. So as you can see here, I'm spending some time figuring out, you know, the best way to make a white outline around the stickers. It turns out being, you know, kind of pointless at the end because I just printed out on white paper and I didn't make any, you know, markings around the white to make it, you know, stick out. So in the future, if I were to sell this as a digital download, I'd spend some time kind of sprucing it up and making the white lines, you know, more clear and pretty, maybe adding a border, but I don't know. We'll see if that's what I want to do with it. Still good practice for me. And here it is all printed out. I really like how it turned out. The colors are not perfect, but I think they're still passable, and everything just looks really cute. Super easy. I just printed it out on my regular printer on sticker paper. And this is me pretending that I'm going to put some stickers on my daily planner. I'm tempted, but it's just a very permanent thing. So maybe I can get over that if I continue making stickers. But I think so far the one in the bottom corner is still my favorite. I like the one in the top corner with the kitty. The evil cactus is also very, very fun. And who doesn't like hearts and rainbows? Anyway, thank you all so much for joining me in this process. I hope you can join me again next time. I make weekly videos, so be sure to subscribe to see my next video. And please do, you know, take a second to hit that like button. It helps me out a lot. YouTube doesn't know that I'm here right now, so the more noise I get, the better, I guess. Anyway, I hope that everyone is doing wonderful this weekend and moving forward. Happy arting, everyone. Thank you.